creepy pair of underwear. Creepy pair of underwear. Jasper Rabbit needed new underwear. On Thursday, Mom took him to the underwear store and grabbed the last three packages of plain white, but as they headed for the checkout, Jasper spotted them. Creepy underwear, so creepy, so comfy. They were glorious. Mom, can we get these? Jasper pleaded. I think they're a little too creepy, said Mom. They're not creepy. They're cool, said Jasper. I'm not a little bunny anymore. I'm a big rabbit now. Mom agreed to buy one pair. That night, Jasper wore his cool new underwear to bed. Do you want me to leave the hallway light on? Asked Dad. Dad, I'm not a little bunny anymore, said Jasper. I'm a big rabbit now. His dad shut the door, and that's when Jasper noticed. Dun, dun, dun! The underwear glowed. A ghoulish, greenish glow. He closed his eyes. He pulled up the covers. He buried his face in his pillow, but it didn't help. He could still see that ghoulish, greenish glow. Jasper leaped out of bed and put on a pair of plain white. He stuffed the creepy underwear into the bottom of his laundry hamper. He finally fell asleep. He finally fell asleep. Dun, dun. Jasper threw them into the garbage can. He was still a big rabbit. He wasn't scared or anything. But he was done with scary underwear. After school, Jasper was doing his homework when he heard it, a scratchy, scraping sound coming from his dresser. He opened the dresser and... Dun! They were back! Dun, dun, dun!
Superman
staring at him with that ghoulish, greenish glow. He snatched the creepy underwear out of his dresser. He grabbed a big envelope and some stamps. Bye-bye, scary underwear, he said, dropping the package in the mailbox to China. When he opened the front door the next day, there they were. And were those chopsticks? His creepy pair of underwear had somehow returned from China, and it had brought back souvenirs. What the heck is that thing? Sock? Jasper grabbed his mom's good sewing scissors, but she didn't like him using them. But this was an underwear emergency. This time, the creepy underwear were gone for good! Ooh, do, 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 do. We're gone for good. At bedtime, he slowly opened his underwear drawer. Nothing, just plain white undies. He searched under his bed. He shook out his lampshades. Woo, there was no sign of creepy underwear. He went into the bathroom to comb his ears. They were back!
Dun, dun, dun!
Loki bit me.
Yeah, he did bite me.
What's the matter with you? His mom asked. You're so jittery lately. Nothing, he yelped. A grown rabbit couldn't be terrified of his underpants.
This crack and hopper field.
Yeah. No, wait.
Yeah, crack.
He.
Seized
the underwear. He snagged a shovel from the garage, and he rode. He didn't stop pedaling until he reached Creakin Hill. Jasper began to dig. He dug until his hole was dark and deep, and 100% underwear proof. He dropped the underwear in the gleamed from the bottom that ghoulish,
greenish blue.
But not for long. When he got home, Jasper crept up to his dresser. They couldn't be in there. There was no way, right? He reached for the handle. He peeked in, nothing, just plain white. Jasper smiled and turned out the light.
Duh! It's pitch black!
There was just one problem. It was really dark in there, even for a big rabbit. Jasper turned on the light. He looked at his non-glowy pair of plain white, and he knew what he had to do. The creepy underwear were a little muddy, but they still filled the room with that gentle greenish.
Magic trick.
The next day, Jasper gathered his allowance money and went to the underwear store all by himself, dressed like a big rabbit. That night, Jasper wasn't scared at all as he lay down to sleep. He smiled, so and so did his underwear, because they had finally found somebody who wasn't scared of creepy underwear.
Ew, this one's doing a kissy lip.
Happy.
Bye-bye. Bye, little Nana and Papa. Do, 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 do. Bye.